Perfect song for this segment, little Kelly Clarkson, Miss Independence. So we're talking about women and men. Welcome back, everyone. We all know that men and women are so different in so many ways.
Yeah, but how do we differ when it comes to managing our finances? Les Szarka from Szarka Financial joins us now with some investment tips, as he does every other Tuesday here. So glad to see you. Men and women, you know, do we invest differently? Do we have different ways of going about things?
Are you hunters and gatherers when it comes to finances?
Great question. And it's funny because 36 years I've been doing this, there is definitely a difference, a philosophical difference. And if I could, now obviously there's gonna be exceptions, but generally speaking, men are tinkerers. They love to tinker, change things. Mm. Women tend to be more patient. So women worry more, men tinker too much. And so if I can make an observation, I think over a longer term period of time, women tend to be better investors because they're more patient. They don't jump from one to another, and men tend to overthink, overreact at times. But at the same time, again, women worry more, but I don't think they spend enough time trying to come out with solutions. So there's good news and bad news on both sides, but I think both sides could actually improve a little bit.
What do you think for the guys? I mean, invest more in gold?
Absolutely, just gold chains and gold bars and, you know.
Yeah, right. No, but we need to settle down. Because we always want that quick fix. We want to fix the problem. If there's a problem, we want to fix it. Yep. But we need to be more like the ladies and just relax.
Men are impatient, and so consequently, they'll jump back and forth, and we tend to jump at the worst times. We know the first rule of investing, buy low, sell high. Unfortunately, we do the opposite. You always want to buy high and sell low. And so consequently, if you're making a lot of movements, you're leaving yourself more opportunity to make mistakes and do it at the worst time. If you're more patient, then you're more likely to wait out these longer periods of time. But I think even more importantly, not just on the investing side, you know, when it comes to finances in general, I think, you know, women do kind of start the race a little bit behind in the sense that a lot of women take time out to raise families, so they're going to miss some of those peak earning years, which then hurts them in terms of putting money aside in the first place. But then also when it comes, you know, time to retire for their pensions and Social Security benefits also tend to be a little bit smaller. You add to the fact that women tend to live longer than men do, so you really compound the problem. So, you know, I would really encourage women, if you're still working, make sure you're putting away enough for retirement. You know, and if you're already retired, one of the things I would just caution is be careful not being too generous. And I think I might have mentioned this a few segments ago, where we talk about how sometimes, you know, our heart is more generous than what our wallet can afford. And so at times we want to help our kids, we want to help our grandkids, and sometimes to our own detriment. You know, so if you're already retired, just be careful before you start helping other folks out. You got to make sure the mothership is taken care of first.
That's really hard to do, though, because that's just our what's innate to us, to be a mother and to make sure everyone's okay. And to be, I'm more worried about my children's future actually than my own, where I need to worry about that too.
And you throw into the equation grandchildren, you know, I'm blessed now, I have 3 grandkids, and you know, it that changes the whole dynamics. I mean, that if you think you're close to your kids, wait till you have grandchildren. And then, and to see them suffer hurting, you know, it's very difficult to say no in those instances. But in many cases I've seen where it's done to their own detriment. So, you know,
so start early, especially for women, because we're not doing
early,
that enough.
Give till it hurts a little bit. You know, and the other thing I would just mention too with women is they tend sometimes to be even too cautious for their own good. In the past, it didn't hurt as much because you could get 4, 5, 6% on a CD. Today, you're getting 0.5%, 0.25%, and so consequently, if you're in that, still in that safe mode, you're just not generating enough income, and you're running a risk of running out of money. So, you know, you kind of have to maybe come out of that cocoon a little bit and get a little bit more aggressive with your investments, you know, if you've been very, very cautious. But at the same time, be very, very patient. This isn't the time that you really want to be jumping in, you know, at least not before the election.
Great advice as always, Les. Appreciate it. Now, if you have financial questions or need more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can simply head to our website, fox8.com, click on Seen on TV. We always learn something.
Yeah, that's what we can talk about next time, too, is getting close to the election and how that can all change
things,
right?
Oh, I'd love to do that one.
All right, let's do that next topic. All right.